What to Play presents the top 15 Switch JRPGs of all time, all arranged by PlayScore. To check out our full list, visit our website at whattoplay.com. You can also take part in our rankings by leaving reviews of the games that you played. If you want to become part of our growing community, we have a Patreon page. Check it out. Link in the description box below. At 15th place is Ys 8, Lacrimosa of Dana. The Switch is a treasure trove of JRPGs, and Nihon Falcom's beloved Ys series opens our list. Adol the Red's adventures have come a long way. In Lacrimosa of Dana, his perpetual quest to save the world from doom now involves a mysterious blue-haired girl. Together, they go on a heroic quest where JRPG tropes combine, a play score of 8.14. 14th spot is The World Ends With You, Final Remix. This is the definitive experience for this banger JRPG from Square Enix. Help Neku and his buddies play the Reaper's game and overcome your fate by engaging in stylish real-time action. In the Switch, the 3DS dual-screen functionality is simplified for a smoother experience. It features enhanced visuals and improved sound for that good old Shibuya scrambles. Tetsuya Nomura's madness knows no bounds, especially now that Nioh: The World Ends With You is coming out soon. A play score of 8.14. Target acquired. 13th place is Final Fantasy VII. The most popular FF title is on the Switch. No, it doesn't look good as its counterpart, but none can beat this classic. It's not the remake we were looking for, but it's the complete experience that once shaped the genre. Enjoy a sprawling story centered around Cloud and his friends and save the world from a silver-haired warrior with mommy issues. A play score of 8.16. Ranking 12th on the list is Trials of Mana. Speaking of remakes, this renowned JRPG released in 1995 gets the makeover it deserves. The Mana series continues to be a strong franchise, even in 2021. Rebuilt from the ground up, new players will find the world of Mana magical. Meanwhile, series veterans will appreciate the many additions to its story and gameplay, including a 3D mode. A play score of 8.35. In our 11th spot is Disgaea 4 Complete Plus. Yet another complete Disgaea experience, on its fourth mainline entry though. This time, NIS is trying to get more people for the Switch console. The Netherworld has a ton of stuff to do this time around. This complete edition contains a handful of new content that is sure to satisfy old and new fans. Its combination of tactical and JRPG elements makes for a time-sinking experience. It's still goofy at times, but that's the fun in Disgaea. It receives a play score of 8.42. Over here at 10th place is Octopath Traveler. Square Enix's ambitious JRPG follows a tale about 8 major characters. Borrowing notable concepts and mechanics from their previous works, Final Fantasy and Chrono Trigger, Octopath Traveler is a treasure trove of all things great about the JRPG genre. Its colorful turn-based battles with branching JRPG narratives gives players more room for replayability, so make sure you pick your first character wisely. A play score of 8.51. 9th in the ranking is Bravely Default 2. The freshest game on this list. It's the much-anticipated follow-up to the 3DS Flying Fairy and a direct sequel to End Lair. Fans had a lot of expectations from 2 considering that the original is hailed as one of the best JRPGs in recent memory. It garnered critical acclaim, gaining numerous 9s on our What to Play database. Many critics praised its return to form, blending their old and new styles within a complex JRPG system. A play score of 8.56. 8th place is Tales of Vesperia, Definitive Edition. 2008 was a long time ago. Over the years, the Tales games have proved themselves as a strong competitor in the JRPG arena. Bandai Namco's anthological saga differs in every title, and this Definitive Edition contains 2 new characters with their own stories. With a play score of 8.57, Vesperia is considered by many as the best Tales game. Sitting on 7th place is Atelier Ryza, Ever Darkness and the Secret Hideout. a cult favorite and a strong entry title for first-timers of the Atelier series. It's a wild mix of hardcore JRPG mechanics and charming slice-of-life elements. Like the rest of the Atelier series, Synthesis is its bread and butter. Combine resources from the materials you gathered on your journey either by fighting enemies or finding treasures. It's a chill game, and Rise's vibrant personality warms players' hearts. Well, they did say, thick thighs save lives. A play score of 8.62. Sixth in the ranking is Ni No Kuni, Wrath of the White Witch. Anyone who adores Studio Ghibli movies will find this JRPG enchanting. That's because most of its art design is crafted by the talented people behind your favorite Ghibli films. In The Wrath of the White Witch, the adventure your main character goes through is nothing short of magical. It brings out our long-forgotten childlike wonders. Even its sequel, Revenant Kingdom, brings more magic than usual. A play score of 8.81. Fifth in our list is Final Fantasy XII: The Zodiac Age. When it comes to JRPG lists, expect more than just one Final Fantasy. XII's renewed flavor in the Zodiac Age brings more depth than the original, making this the definitive way to experience the journey of Vaughn and his friends. The International Zodiac system is but one of the many improvements the game offers. This also includes a myriad of quality of life fixes that completely change the way we play XII. It's a solid remaster that receives a play score of 8.84. Our fourth spot belongs to Rune Factory 4 Special. Rune Factory's following was a result of Harvest Moon's success. While the games aren't that similar, most of Rune Factory's mechanics might be familiar to fans of Marvel's Farming Sim. Think of it as Harvest Moon on steroids. In 4 Special, lead a new life as an amnesiac. It's pretty much like the original, but the extra story mode where you can find the love of your life and marry them adds a whole new meaning to life sims. A play score of 8.84. Our third place is Xenoblade Chronicles Definitive Edition. Wield the Monado in this living legacy from the days of the Nintendo Wii. This Definitive Edition is the perfect game for players who are new to the Xenoblade franchise. Follow Shulk as he goes on an epic quest involving massive mechs and titans. As a remastered version, it works well on the Switch, offering hours and hours of JRPG goodness, including a new epilogue. It's an ambitious game that's made even better with its next title, Xenoblade Chronicles 2. Xenoblade Chronicles Definitive Edition receives a play score of 9.03. Second place is Fire Emblem Three Houses, Nintendo's anime version of Hogwarts without the wands and evil wizards. Three Houses is Fire Emblem at full force. Craft your own journey in a story that spans three massive houses, where you meet unlikely personalities and forge relationships. However, that's just the game's social aspect. Fire Emblem has always been a tactical JRPG, and you deal with schoolwork on one side and wage war on the other. A play score of 9.11. Standing tall at first place is Dragon Quest XI S, Echoes of an Elusive Age Definitive Edition. The king of Switch's JRPG list, this lengthy name of a lengthy title excels in its fantastic presentation of living that JRPG fantasy. Take down enemies in its vibrant real-time combat. As the Luminary, save the world and meet a ragtag group of characters across the sprawling kingdom. Looking at its critic scores and gamer reviews, there's no doubt this Dragon Quest game is the series' best. A play score of 9.26. Before we end our video, we thank these What to Players for supporting our channel through Patreon. For just a dollar, you can have your name in the credits of our next video and get exclusive What to Play rewards. Become our patron now by visiting our page through the link below.